You get a chance, make another double espresso, Paulie. What do you want, a tea?
Yeah, Angola tea.
A tea for Paulie? Ooh, a regular?
Regular coffee, American.
A regular coffee for Suits, and a double espresso for the other Paulie.
It's a Manchu.
Casa Grande Special.
What's up? Hey, Paul.
Like, how are you? Hey, Paul.
Miguel, how you doing, buddy?
Miguel.
Oh. Only person we're missing is Squiggy now.
Squiggy is actually downtown, I think.
Downtown, no, Squiggy Brown.
He's doing something for the Godfather sequel, a book.
Oh, yeah?
Where he's going to be on the picture, be in the picture of it?
Oh, I don't know. Good for him.
Awesome.
Good for him. I spoke to him the other day. He was actually here yesterday, too. You were here yesterday, no?
Squiggy's a funny bastard.
Bro. Oh, you can't beat Squiggy. He's the best.
Got the best stories.
Hey, Paulie, I got a question.
What's up, Bob?
What's the best cigar to smoke if you're just starting up?
The best cigar to smoke if you're just starting out is, I would say, a nice Torpedo Connecticut. It's...
Hey, funny, I'm from Connecticut.
Yeah, he is, actually, right? Imagine.
Connecticut shade wrapper with a mild wrapper around it. It's very mild, nutty, creamy. It won't be overbearing. And,
But, Suits, for you, we're going to create something different.
For a guy your size, you need something twice the size.
Something like that, but in a pastrami flavor.
Hey, there you go.
How's that?
I love that.
Okay. You guys see all the movie trucks in the neighborhood? I think they're filming a movie up here down the block.
What's the name? Joaquin Phoenix.
Joaquin Phoenix is starring in it. And
I thought it was a bunch of agents.
It's about
that's what I thought it was.
No, I thought they were making a big deal about this guy.
The whole setting is like 1920s.
Yeah?
Really?
Yeah. Who's it about? Like what kind of Italians?
I think it's a Polish, some Polish movie. Immigrants, people coming here from Poland. Yeah.
You heard about the Polish hockey team that drowned?
No, I have.
Spring training. Cigars, honestly, the first one ever smoked. I smoked my first one when I was bouncing at the China Club when I was about 18, 19 years old. Dunhill Cabrera.
Oh, Dunhill.
Very, very mild cigar. What about you, John?
Me?
Yeah, what was your first cigar?
My first cigar was
made in a hurry.
The Noboli.
Noboli.
You must have had a lot of mosquitoes around.
I took it from my grandfather's stack. My grandfather always walked around with two packs of the Nobilis. He's always in the park playing quarters. Remember the tables in the park? They had the checkerboard on them?
They used to play
nickels and quarters. Whatever the hell they used to play. They used to play Scoba and this and that, nickels and dimes. And one night or one morning, whatever it was, I just took one out of his box. I said, I gotta see. He's always chewing on it, you know? I didn't fucking know. I took the thing, I lit it up. I almost died. I took one puff like that. I don't know how to fucking light a cigar. I'm 11 years old or something like that. And I just took one puff and I almost died. The fucking thing, forget it. Nasty mother. And then after I got into the habit of smoking those things, but I smoked the Avantis with the Anisette in them.
They got Anisette.
Yeah, that's why it's my first cigar.
You remember what they used to call them cigars, right?
What, the Nobly?
Guinea stinkers.
Guinea sticks or something like that.
Guinea stinkers.
Yeah. Yeah,
and that was
first
in the
cigar.
Movie Casino too. Remember they ate the attract. What did they say?
Yeah, he says they all their bosses. They're in their homes, smoking their Danobles, eating soufrit and adrip.
That's all the old times you smoke. And I remember the packs. They were like 90 cents a pack. Now they're like $5-6 a
they
pack.
They make them in Pennsylvania with chopped tobacco. It's all chopped stuff.
Oh, yeah?
They make in Pennsylvania.
Yeah, those things are strong, bro.
We're gonna do a raffle this week. Miguel, come over, Bill.
Come over here. One per customer, Miguel.
Paul Logan Backer.
Logan
Anvil
Backer.
Anvil Fire Company. Anvil PA.
That sounds like a character from a Marx Brothers movie.
Make sure his email's
Captain
on
Paul
there.
Captain Paul Logan Backer.
The email there.
Paul Logan Backer. What'd I tell you, Paul? Backer. Put the email, Paul. What'd I tell you? Well, we got a phone
Who's
number.
Who's this coming? Who do we got coming? Oh, special guest stars?
There you go.
Boys. What's that, Big Red?
Yeah,
what's that?
You guys are with the 817?
817.
We're with the 187.
187.
So seriously, you know, where'd you put...
282.
Where did they put half of?
282. All right, stop. That's another charge.
It's going to be a charge. Insane. Hold on.
Oh, look at this. Look at this picture. Oh, this is great.
Take it sideways because we're all big guys.
Okay, that looks
Hey, take one with my phone so we have one. Snap two
points. Yeah, Paul. Oh,
I would say smoke this on the way home, but you have to ride.
You probably piss out in the trunk.
If you're driving to Alaska, that'd be perfect.
Ready?
What guy's gonna get called in for a deposition next week? You don't even know.
You just bought yourself a night.
You guys are thirsty after work.
I hope you're able to retire and your pension's locked in.
I'm there all night.
With this shot.
I'll be bartending tonight, too.
You just bought yourself 17 indictments with those bitches.
Yeah, if you guys want to go to my sister's bar tonight and have a drink, because
I'm the bartender.
He runs the place right down the block. They know Mux.
Extra suits. Danny suits.
I'm here. I'm at the boss. I'm looking for
something. Are you sure? Bring the guys over. Tell them come have a cannoli and a coffee.
When you shooting tomorrow? You shooting tomorrow too?
Oh, just today? So stop by 5 minutes. We'll get a little mozzarella, a little prosciutto, something. Sit have a coffee.
I know his freaking luck. He's going to have the shot with Joaquin Phoenix. He's going to have the shot. He'll be on the fucking next movie with Joaquin Phoenix. And I got to hear about it for the next 3 years.
I didn't know it was him.
Well, you can make believe I'm
not. You don't know Joaquin Phoenix?
I have no idea, no.
Joaquin Phoenix was in the movie.
He's got a scar on his lip.
He played young. Did you watch Gladiator?
Yeah.
You saw the prince that was a cockroach. He killed his own father.
Get Saverin.
I don't remember.
He's the one who killed the gladiator at the end.
Yeah.
You threw a spear at him.
You're thinking about the Brad Pitt movie.
I'm talking about 300.
Troy.
He's talking about Troy.
You say 300.
Shane.
No, wait.
He's the prince.
Wait. Wasn't it Ben Hur?
He's the king.
No, it's Ben Him.
But he stabbed him. He stabbed him with what's his name? The actor.
I don't remember.
Russell Crowe.
He stabbed Russell Crowe.
And We Own the Night. That was a good movie about the Russian mob.
Yeah.
You didn't see that? We Own the Night?
I think so. That's an old movie.
That's not old. 3 years old. What's old to you?
Oh,
5 years.
That's old.
Yeah. No, what's that other one? The other one.
Movies coming out every friggin' day.
with the spots, the alien movie with Mel Gibson. What was that?
Aviator.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. It was a baseball play.
Yes. Yeah.
Smacking like, the shit out of me.
That was
Aviator. Oh, I know what you're talking about.
I don't watch TV. I don't watch TV. I'm gonna be on TV.
He's smacking shit.
Yeah, he's smacking shit out of an alien.
with the field when he's playing
ball.
Yeah, that was a good fucking.
Yeah, that was good.
Yeah, he had the dreams, and then he sees his father in the field at the end. Right, was that the one?
Field of Dreams.
That's the one I'm talking about. That was a great fucking movie.
Oh, that's Kevin Costner.
Yeah.
That's not Joaquin Phoenix.
That's not Joaquin.
I don't know. Whatever. We're here. That's all that matters, right? We're having coffee. Salute. Love you all.
Week's cigar of the week is the Double Hemingway. Hey. Double Hemingway is bigger than the regular Hemingway, so that's how you know the significance. Right. It's a big, fat, big boy. Look at that shape. Best cigar, end of story. Well, I just say that because there's another brand that calls this kind of shape a short story or a long story or a signature. This is one of our specialty cigars. It's a 5-leaf Dominican tobacco with a Brazilian Maduro wrapper. I'm going to give the cigar to Giovanni as a gift. And on top, I know he's not going to smoke because he only smokes his signature cigar.
Yeah, but come on, maybe look at this. This is gorgeous.
We'll see if you can go see Joaquin. You're a star now.
This is like making love to a girl right here. It's like, hey, sweetheart, how are you? How you doing?
You can
drive more like making love to Timo.
It
looks more like making love to Timo Perez.
No, but this is a good cigar. I like it. Dark leaf, too. It's nice. Just relaxing. Having a cognac.
If you put in the code word Joaquin Phoenix, or just Phoenix, with a PH or an F, whatever way you spell it, we're all from the Bronx. So Phoenix is the code word. You put that in with a $50 order, you get a Hemingway.
Make sure
you put your emails in, please.
And make some more movies about Italians in this neighborhood. Remember that. Then forget it. Guys, I'll see you later.
Paulie, God bless. Love you.
Marlene's. Love you, Paulie.
Good.
Any suits?
Paulie. Oh,
you know, one day we're gonna go do the next picking. We might go to suits. We'll go to the bar over there and do a drawing over there.
There we go.
Have a drink.
I go crazy looking around liquor.
Yeah?
You know how a Frenchman holds his liquor, right? By his ears.